Hello and welcome to Tech Deals. Can you get high quality music and game sound out of your computer for $20? No, of course not. But you can, however, A, get sound that works, and B, yeah, pretty much the first one, sound that works. Today we're taking a look at the Logitech Z200 $20 stereo speaker system. And compared to these $10 speakers, they are perfectly adequate. They are not complete crap. They are absolutely functional in all respects that they were designed for. If you want actual deep bass sounds, well, they have none. They have no powered sub. If you want high quality mid-range and high quality high-end sound, yeah, they don't really have that either. Did I mention that they're better than $10 speakers? Yay! Now, if you are a longtime viewer of my channel, you may be watching this video going, what in the world is Mr. Deals on about? This is not sounding like his normal excited, quick, go buy this now, it's amazing product review. It's not, because I'm honest. And these are adequate. And that's about the best thing I can say about them. Now, part of that, to be completely honest and straightforward with you, is because I just got done listening to much nicer speakers, as you can see here on the desk. A couple of days ago, I filmed an unboxing and review of the Z333 over here. Now, that's a $50 set of speakers. This is $20. Of course, they're going to sound better. But of course, once you've heard those, these sound atrocious by comparison. Now, that being said, currently right now on Amazon, you can buy the 2.1 with a powered subwoofer Z313 for less than $10 more than the Z200s. Now, I am not a huge fan of the Z313s. The 333s are much better sounding, but they cost more. However, if you're only looking at these two right here, the 200s versus the 313s, what a difference. Having a real powered sub, and frankly, the satellites are better, makes all the difference in the world. If you have room, there is no excuse to buy the Z200 whatsoever. Buy at least the Z313. If you're on an extreme strict budget and the $50 or $55 price of the 333 is too much for you, fine, get the 313. It is miles ahead in terms of music and game reproduction to the 200. Only buy the 200 if A, that's not an option due to size or space, or yeah, that's pretty much it. If all you need are speakers that work for an office machine, you're not playing music, you're not playing games, actually, these are fine. I own a half a dozen sets of these from my former business, from my office, and I've used these on many business machines because you just need something that makes sound, and it doesn't have to be good. You're not playing music all day through them. You're not playing games through them all day, so you just need something. They're something. They're small. They're not too big. They're USB powered. They're easy to use. If you want more, skip these unless you absolutely have to get a two-speaker sound system without a sub. If you want to play games and music and that's your criteria, they're fine. But the minute you put them next to the 313 or 333, frankly, they're crap and I wouldn't buy them. This might very well be the shortest Tech Deals video ever. Well, not really, but it's going to be close. However, I do want to provide a close look at these, and then I'm going to provide a bonus look at those S150 digital USB speakers in just a second. Looking at the front of the speakers, you can see that we've got two white rings, and that's going to continue along the side. There is trim running on both sides and down the back on the actual stand itself, so hopefully you like a white and black trimmed speaker. Now, this is accompanied with wonderful cheap black plastic that catches every fingerprint and smudge on earth. Frankly, trying to keep this clean would be next to impossible. Thankfully, generally speakers are something you just put on your desk and don't touch, so once you've got it there and you've got it clean, it shouldn't be too much of an issue, but be aware that it's that wonderful black fingerprinty plastic. On the other speaker, we have a volume knob in the center, we have a microphone in, and we have an auxiliary in jack, which is a nice feature if you want to input, say, an MP3 player or an iPod, which, does anybody have those anymore? Well, you could if you want to. Now, over here on this side, we have a pitch shift knob. The back of the box claims, adjust your pitch and your bass response with this. Yeah, all that does is make them sound worse. I played with that, frankly, it's not impressive. I said it before at the beginning of the video, I'll say it again. If good full range sound is something you're looking for, you won't find it here. They're speakers. They work. and they make sound, and they're better than those. As for the cables, this is interesting. Now, this is the cable that runs to the back of your computer, and it's fairly long, it's decently long, it's probably long enough so long as this isn't too far off to the side from your machine. What's interesting is the cable connecting these two is absolutely ridiculously long, so long that I actually can barely make it straight. And I've got decently long arms, I'm 6 feet tall. And that is a very long cable that connects these two. Now, the cable that runs to the power for the wall is plenty long because, of course, that's not going to be where your computer is. So, interestingly enough, the cable is almost too long between them and maybe a little short running from the speaker to your computer, depending upon where it is, of course. Okay, that's enough of that. Quick bonus look at the S150s. These are $10 USB digital speakers. There is no 3.5 millimeter jack. They do not use the sound card in your computer. There is no external power brick whatsoever. There is one cable. Plug it into any USB port on any moderately sort of semi-reasonable computer. The drivers will install themselves, the computer will detect it, and they will simply function. There is a volume control up and down digital here on the front with a mute button in the middle. This does not adjust the speakers, it actually adjusts Windows volume. If you get onto the little sound icon in Windows and you click it, you drag the sound, that's actually what this does. This actually makes Windows sound go up and down because they're digital speakers. Now, as I said, these are not great speakers. The music and the gaming sound of these is frankly pretty terrible. The main purpose is to provide basic sound for businesses or other things. Because they are USB powered, because there's no external power brick, they're very easy to install. They don't take up a lot of space. The cabling is not remotely an issue. They're just cheap. But again, $10, it provides sound. I hope this video was interesting, informative, or maybe just entertaining for you. Like this video if you like it. Share it with your friends if you loved it. Remember to subscribe to my channel with the big, huge red button directly below. Questions and comments in the comment section. And as always, check the links in the video description. Everything you see here will be linked down in the video description below. Please use those links when you're shopping. They are affiliate links. They do support the channel, and I would be eternally grateful if you are able to do so. Thanks so much for watching. I will see you in the next video.